in row,
and you're watching MTV. Check it out.
It was August 13th, 1965. Watts was burning. My best friend, JT, was burning too. Burning with hatred, with a rage fueled by so many years of harassment, discrimination, and intolerance. We were separated by choices. How did this happen? How did so many fall prey to this despair? I remember so clearly how we felt when we left Alabama for California only 6 years ago. The hope was so sweet, you could taste it.
Talking to you.
Nothing, Daddy.
We ain't stopping every half hour for you to use the toilet.
I don't need to use the toilet, Daddy.
Honey, you getting caught, too?
No,
oh,
Mom, I'm not
in here.
I ain't sick, Bobby. My butt fell asleep.
Don't look at me. I ain't waking it up.
His butt fell asleep. California, boy. Land opportunity. Because a man can make it in Alabama, ain't no telling what he can do in Los Angeles.
Lots of good jobs out there. Airplane factories.
Beaches.
Palm trees.
Girls.
Aluminum factories.
Lena Horne.
Lots of new buildings need to be built.
Lena Horne.
Good schools for the boys.
Lena Horne.
Enough of this Lena Horne. That's all I've been hearing for the last 6 months, Lena Horne. If you're so partial to Miss Horne, you should have married Lena Horne in the first place.
What's the address? Maybe there's still time.
Oh, I'm sorry, baby. No more Lena Horne, I promise. She ain't got nothing on you anyhow.
Yeah.
'Cause now, that Dorothy Dandridge is something else.
You crazy.
Thank you.
came by the thousands. It was California, the colorblind dream. No more separate but equal. It wasn't Los Angeles out there. It was the Emerald City, the promised land.
This handsome young man here. That wouldn't be JT, but... Well, come on, is a smile all I'm gonna get? You better come over here and give me some sugar. Look at you. Oh, you devil, you. I always thought you'd turn out to be a little devil.
You boys start unloading the car.
Pass that butter by. My dear, when we get bus to Hollywood, we want to see what it looks like up close.
Nothing for you in Hollywood. Besides, you got to walk 3 miles just to get your bus. And we're going to church in a little bit. I tell you what, though. After church, the two of you can go do a little sightseeing. But stay close to home, and for God's sakes, don't go nowhere near Alameda Street.
Church? My dear, I was thinking that maybe me and JT could probably skip church today. Maybe stick around here and help you pick up some groceries or something. I really want to do more than just pull my own weight. And I promised Mom I'd help you out any way I could, so I really think it best for everybody involved if maybe me and JT would just stick around here and sacrifice our day with the Lord for the sake of our loved ones.
Volunteered your services for the welcoming committee's friendship hour. Feel free to excuse yourselves at this time.
You know, when our eyes first met, the Lord told me, Bobby, I want you to go that extra mile and volunteer. Did you know that the Bible teaches us that the best love is pure love? That pure love isn't angry, and pure love, well, it ain't selfish or jealous. It asks us to give our love freely, and I guess that's what the Lord was trying to tell me the moment I saw you.
That's beautiful, but I have work to do.
All the brethren greet you. Greet ye one another with a holy kiss. Now that pure love, it's a beautiful thing. And if you're not too busy this evening, we can talk lots more about pure love. I'm Bobby Richardson. What's your name?
Lotta.
What's going on here?
Out here. You bolted from the service. I thought you were taken ill.
Well, everything was fine, Mr. Jackson, till I come here and catch my grandson carrying on with Lotta.
That's a very stylish brooch you have on there, Ruth Anna. Makes your eyes sparkle even more.
The Reverend's going to introduce you as soon as the music stops. I'm going back inside, and I want you right behind me. Lord have mercy.
I'm going to see you.
Flirting in the house of the Lord. Imagine that.
So I didn't mean no harm. I was just...
Son, you're trying to catch a young quail. You can't grab her too hard. You might crush her to death. Gotta hold her just tight enough so she won't get away. Young girls are the same way.
Well,
lift your spirit.
Excuse me, my dear. Me and JT want to know if we can go grab a snow cone. That's okay?
Her back, sugar.
And give us to you.
I tell you.
JT.
JT.
Look here. If Muddy don't want us to go to Hollywood, you know it's a place to be.
That's the show love truth.
I tell you what, let's get over that way and find a place to catch this bus, all right? Come on, JT, let's make it.
I don't know, Bobby.
I'm going to Hollywood. You coming or not?
All this, man. Let's grab us a couple cokes and find us some girls.
See, here it is. Late Sunday afternoon. All the pretty ones at home helping their moms with supper. Besides, I bet Hollywood full of pretty girls.
Right now, I'd settle for an ugly girl from Watts.
Right over there.
Thanks a lot. Morning. Name's Clifford Turpin. Several of your men told me you're looking to hire a finished carpenter.
Nope.
Excuse me, sir, but I was just told you were.
Nope, you heard wrong.
But your men... Well, are you hiring for any positions?
We don't have anything. Sorry.
We run a union shop, or we need somebody with more experience. More experience? I had 45 men working under me back home. 45. And that ain't experience enough for a job as a framer? I had to tell about 20 places who stay behind. And they take one look at me, tell me to go on.
If it happened,
we're
exploited Kinsfields for 10 years. They're good people. She does all kinds of charity work, and he's a corporation lawyer downtown and knows lots of very important people. And I just know one of them has a job for Clifford Turpin.
I don't need nobody's charity.
So tell me, Mr. Turpin, what are your plans after Fremont?
Jet pilot.
Excuse me?
I said I want to be a jet pilot. See, I'm from Alabama, and my great uncle was a pilot with the Tuskegee Airmen during World War II. You know, the Red Tails. I guess you could say flying's in my blood.
You mean you want to become a commercial airline pilot?
Yeah, that's right. Kind of always been a dream of mine.
JT, In order to pursue that kind of career, you'd have to understand things like navigation and hydraulics.
Yeah, I want to learn all that.
In order to master that, you would have to take calculus, physics, and all the other hard sciences.
Well, I had a semester of chemistry. Well, I got a B- in algebra, and I even helped out some of the other kids.
You're talking about college, JT. Now, even though some of your grades in academics are quite good, your college board scores are rather low.
Well, I can do the work. I ain't stupid.
No one's saying you are.
Look, I don't care what you're trying to sell me. I want to fly jets.
Okay. Hey. JT. How'd you make out?
I told the GC I wanted to go into auto mechanics.
What the hell you talking about?
Well, me being so good in shopping all.
T, you and I always wanted to fly jets. You and me gonna enlist. See the world, don't give up on that.
Yeah, but it takes a long time to do all that. You gotta learn calculus, physics, all that crap. Now, I wanna live for today. Make my money now.
What the hell did they tell you in there?
Nothing I don't already know.
Remember I told you about Clem and your Turpin to come here with Bobby?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Mr. Turpin, Clifford,
mm-hmm.
He's an experienced construction worker, but he's having a terrible time finding work. Mm-hmm. I thought that since Mr. Kinfield knows so many important people that maybe he might help.
Go. I'll have you a referral by the morning. How's that?
Meat was excellent, Ruth Anna.
Peppercorns and seasoned salt, just the way you like it.
Darling, I ran into one of the senior partner's wives today, Mrs. Bluebelt.
Blauvelt, honey.
Yes, and I asked her if she would help me get the word out about the Child Guidance Center fundraiser at the cocktail party, and guess what? She volunteered to be a host.
Where'd you see Jeannie Blauvelt? They live in Hancock Park, don't they?
Saks.
Saks.
Coffee, Mr. Kinfield?
You've done it again, haven't you?
Oh, Richard.
Now, it's for Miss Kinfield to find that dress, and she looked mighty pretty in it.
That's not the issue, Ruth Anna.
Well, now, I wasn't going to say nothing about this, because it just ain't none of my business. But I don't know too many women who would dig into their grocery money just so they could look special for their husband's law firm cocktail party now.
Fine. You can keep the damn dress.
Oh, shucks. Come on, honey. You know how men's are. If they don't feel like they rule the nest, they crack open all the eggs just to prove who got the biggest beak.
Lord have mercy.
I don't know how much longer this grocery money line is going
to work. Don't worry about sugar.
Turpin, there's a lot of good things about you. By the way, welcome to Los Angeles and the Lowe's Construction Company.
Thank you.
So tell me about yourself.
Well, I moved my family here about 8 weeks ago from Birmingham, Alabama. Back home, I was in charge of 45 men on a construction team. I was in charge of everything. Framing, masonry work, plumbing, electrical.
So you were on a construction team, masonry, electrical, et cetera, et cetera. Mr. Turpin, maybe some mistake was made.
Do you?
Well, exactly what position are you applying for?
My construction foreman. Sir, is there some kind of problem?
Mr. Turpin, I don't know how to say this, but the job you are applying for just isn't available anymore. My supervisor told me that you were seeking a janitorial position in one of our office buildings. That was obviously some mix-up.
Mix-up?
Look, I'm terribly sorry. It wasn't my intention to take up your time of bringing you all the way down. Can I get you a cup of coffee?
Take the job.
Mr. Turpin, with all due respect, you are overqualified for this position.
I said I'll take the job.
Sad, 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 yeah. Mm-mm. I don't think we ever have another egg in this house.
Well, how's that, my dear?
Well, it looks like JT and Bob ate up all the chickens in Los Angeles.
Clifford, honey, tell us what happened on the interview today.
Got the job. Cut all that out. Ain't nothing but a job.
Oh, Clifford, honey, dance with me.
Hey, mama, don't you treat me wrong.
A minute now. Phil, don't stop that can on. I'm not gonna give you these four chickens I got here for the Dodgers baseball game next Saturday. Count them. Four.
Dodgers!
What is it, Clifford?
That was a mistake.
What?
Maybe there wasn't no foreman's job. I'm gonna be a gent. A gent.
Wave will return in a moment on TNT.
The Army and didn't understand how profound these changes were. I was young, and all I could think about was making my way in the world. A buddy of mine in the service had set me up to get a job as a messenger at the LA Times. And like any kid, I thought this was my first step toward immortality. I didn't realize just how right I was.
Clearly, one cannot ignore McLuhan's differentiation between hot and cold media, nor his tenet that the medium is the message. But frankly, those who inspired my career choice were not media theorists. The men who inflamed my passions were men like W.E.B. Du Bois, Ambrose Bierce, Edward R. Murrow. See, these men held a mirror to our society and dared us to look. These were the men who became my role models. It is to their standards to which I aspire, and it is for this reason that I have every confidence in the world that should your outstanding publication choose to hire me, I will be the greatest messenger the Los Angeles Times has ever had. And that's the way it is. What do you think?
I think my boyfriend's a lunatic.
LA Times. Think I got a shot?
If Madeira finds out what you and I are doing under her roof, we're both gonna get a shot right between the eyes.
That's
great welcome home, Lotta. Party was nice, too.
I am a Christian girl.
Oh, we know that. You know, I know. Now, listen, what was JT last night?
Probably had something to do with the guys at the car wash.
Now, see, you lower that sheet any further, Christian girl, and this XTI is liable to get religious all over again.
I love you. You
Does a home buyer with the ability to pay have the right to purchase a home where he chooses, or does the owner of the property have the right to choose who he can sell it to?
Hi, yes, Mr. Scott. The issue here is fair housing. I keep hearing realtors
want to. Look at you.
Hey, man. Damn, you look good. Missed you, man.
Ooh, nice dodge. Where you coming from, a funeral?
Yeah. I just laid unemployment to rest. I pulled it off, JT. Got me a gig at the L.A. Times.
Yeah, that's cool.
Say, man, why'd you stop writing? Dog get you a pencil?
Figured you was too busy seeing the world.
Come on, man, when was I ever too busy for you? L.A. Times, that's what we were talking about. I'm on my way to the big time.
I got a lot of work to do, man. I'll catch up with you later.
What is your problem?
I ain't got no problem, man. You got the problem. You know, you take a couple classes at Compton College and spend a little time in the Army, and you think you Chet Brinkley or something.
Yeah, so maybe I aim high. What's wrong with that?
Bobby, you're just a nigger, like everybody else. Look, man, I'm sorry.
If I don't have the prettiest home on Summit Drive, I don't know who do.
H.M. or not, I still say my house is a lot bigger and has a much nicer kitchen.
Well, we had movie stars in our house last night, Mr. Moore, Mamsterdam, and Miss Della Reese.
Well, I got me my own star in my own house. Lord have mercy, my grandson done got a job on the L.A. Times. Right. Oh, praise Jesus. I just wish I could figure out their food. What can happen to filthy fish in the
Yes, sir, I've got it. I'm writing it down right now. Are you sure this
is a good one?
Oh,
it's going to the point you do, sir. It's got
me see some coffee up here. Oh, Joe, take a photographer down to the health department. I want to follow up on that slowdown.
You, Jordan.
Where the hell is Art, huh? Chuck, you see that Richfield story?
Dave, explore the collusion angle. We're gonna need 7 more inches.
Frank,
I need this much more space on the Beverly Hills Freeway. So very good, George. Very good. John, I want some more on the Salinger-Kennedy relationship, all right? And can someone please tell me where the hell Art...
You guys got me.
I appreciate the ride, Bobby. If I don't get down to that grocery store real quick, there won't be nothing left on the shelf. Have you seen JT today?
No, ma'am.
Would you talk to him? Yesterday when he left, he went to work and didn't come back. He was drunk.
I'll talk to him.
Next.
I tell you what, I am tired of waiting on Whitey to give us 40 acres and a mule. You think I wanted to sell my car? I'm going to find that white boy that fired me and kick his butt. All I want is a job. Do the work that I was trained to do.
It'll come, Clifford. What I keep hearing from you all is anger, pure and simple. You want everything yesterday. The world don't work that way. What do you think would have happened if Jackie Robinson had gotten angry with every white man that did him wrong?
What am I supposed to do? Sweep up another one of the man's construction sites?
Jackie had the wisdom to understand that if he stood the pain long enough, the whole world would accept him. And the big leagues are full of colored ball players. Yes, sir. Our time will come.
You can talk Jackie Robinson all you want. I got nothing, and I'm damn mad. Come on, Daddy, let's go. Come on. I will go when I'm good and ready. All I want is a job. You give me a job, Junior, and I won't bother nobody.
I understand. Man's got good faith.
Take it easy, man. I just had a little drink, that's all.
Now, why don't you mind your own damn business?
Wait a minute. Hold it. Hold it!
Why don't you back off and tell me what's going on with you? My daddy's a drunk, and he lost his job. You satisfied? Can you get him a job? How about me, Bobby? Can you get me on at the time?
Break to you. Know I just started myself.
Yeah. Bobby's real good at looking out for number one. Well, hooray for Bobby. And to hell with the brothers.
Hey! What's going on here? Somebody's got to remind you. You're more than friends. You're old friends. I don't care how hard you try, you can never find new old friends.
Don't you shut up, old man.
Yeah, I'm old. And I try to live a good Christian life. That don't mean I won't kick the shit out of both of you if you don't fix whatever it is that's broken.
I said you better get it, you know, do the hair right.
I got me a good working dress for church tomorrow. Slits in the front, slits on the side, and a slit in the back. In case I'm getting some action I don't know about.
Well, if my new dress gets Elroy Clayton to notice me before he notices that scheming little Baz Baylor, I know my dress is working good.
Of course, my dad over there's got that handsome peacock, Junius Jackson, just dying to hitch up with her.
Mmm. Oh, girl, you crazy. Junius Jackson ain't got the slightest bit of interest in me, and I'm about to stir up no interest in him either. Mm-hmm. Skiwee, tell me where I can get one of them good working dresses from.
Yeah, I feel God's spirit. I feel here. I feel here. Feel it now.
know that today is a family day, Ruth Anna, and I don't want to bother you, but I had to come over here and tell you, you look absolutely radiant.
Thank you very much, Mr. Jackson. I certainly appreciate the compliment.
The church is having a barbecue for us older folks who have lost our beloved ones.
Uh-huh.
And I would be honored if you would escort me to the festivities.
It is my understanding that the barbecue in question is for those looking to re-enter the matrimonial bond. That, Mr. Jackson, does not include me.
But Ruth Anna,
I say, therefore, to the unmarried and widows, it is good for them if they abide even as I. 1 Corinthians, 7th chapter, 8th verse.
But if they cannot contain, let them marry. For it is better to marry than to burn. Now, I don't know what verse that comes from, but I do hope that you will consider me, Ruth Anna.
All right.
Nothing you can buy can make me tell a lie to my God.
My God.
What? Both of you, hold it right there. Where are you going?
Home.
Where are you coming from?
Listen, what difference does it make? You're gonna FI me no matter what.
Name and address.
Richardson Robert R. 11930 Avalon Boulevard, Los Angeles.
Don't you move. That goes for Trixie Trim, too.
Officer, she's my date.
You see me every weekend walking with my Sunday school class. You know who I am. You know me!
Daddy.
Hold it right there! I said hold it right there!
I'll take care of it.
Hey! What the hell do you think you're doing?
When our officer says stop, you stop.
Oh, what the hell? Are you gonna call down on
me
too?
All right, that's enough.
We haven't done anything.
I know that. We both know that sometimes it doesn't matter. Look, I'm new here, but I know this much. It's better to put up with my partner for 5 minutes and get home in one piece than it is to pull a stunt like you just did and get yourself killed. Have a good night.
You have a nice night.
Wave will return in a moment on TNT.
Your hands up high. You can lift them higher than that, friend. Let's get them up there. The first one drops your hand, dead man.
The constant harassment took its toll. On August 11th, 1965, it was hot, almost 100 degrees. Everybody was out on the streets doing the best they could to keep cool. The day started like any other. You ever let
that freezer cold? You had enough here.
Uh-huh. Money, money, money. Damn, JT. Always leave me behind the eight ball.
And that's exactly where you're gonna stay, Dominic. Right there behind that eight ball. Trying to tell me he know how to shoot some pool.
You know how to shoot some pool.
Now, it's too hot for y'all to be working so hard. Especially you, Junior.
Bless your child.
I just got off the phone talking to Ruth Anna since her death.
Is that right? She's just a regular satin doll, that Ruth Ann. Lovely inside, she is outside. If she ever decides to give up widowing, I hope she gives her juniors a chance.
Junius Jackson.
I'm he. Anything wrong, officer?
Yeah. bought these shoes a couple days ago, and they're killing my feet. I was told you were my best bet. Can you help me out?
Have a seat, officer.
It's Riggs. John Riggs. My partner is going to be back in a minute. Maybe I should just come back later.
Officer, the shoe is what I do. Roxy, get Officer Johnny some lemonade.
Oh, no, no, no.
Where you from, son?
Boyle Heights.
Just as I thought.
Dan,
he's in for a good one.
What is it? Am I gonna live or?
Son? You will live. Here. Put these on.
They feel great. How'd you do that?
Old shoe man's trick. Those shoes are not properly broken in, so I put something in the cushion of the feet. Keeps your dogs from barking.
Huh. What kind of cushion?
Kotex.
You put that in my shoes? What do I owe you?
No charge. Your first time, no charge. Go back now.
Okay, thank you, sir.
See that, Roxy? That's a nice young man. They're not all redneck cowboys.
Officer! Don't forget now, Kotex! Kotex!
What's going on, John?
K-O.
I know what it is.
Kotex!
Art, it's over.
Oh, it can't be over. Why does it have to be over?
It's over because my contact in the Rams front office is on vacation.
Oh.
I haven't tried Meridian Sports. Tickets for the Cowboys game are out of the question. I'm sorry.
I can get you those tickets.
Who the hell are you?
Bob Richardson, sir. I'm a messenger in classifieds. I can get you those tickets and have them for you by the end of business today.
How much?
Face value. How many do you need?
Four. Can you get us four?
Can do.
Here we go. Hey, Mr. Can Do, we really appreciate this.
Yeah, no problem.
Mr. Thomas?
Taking care of.
Four tickets.
Mr. Denby, this is,
Robert Richardson, sir. Thank you. Hi, how are you?
He says he's with the L.A. Times.
Times, huh? That's correct, sir. I was wondering if you might step in your office as I have a rather pressing matter to discuss with you.
Now?
Please.
Mr. Richardson, is it?
Right.
I really don't have the time.
Well, neither do I. So if we could step in your office, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, fellas.
Nice, cool.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, man.
It's getting late, Rich. Girls ain't gonna show, man.
Dominique, you two smashed the drive.
Oh, man, it's only 8 blocks home. What's gonna happen in 8 blocks?
Come on, man. Get the bike.
Well? Mr. Can-Do. You're a genius.
Well, I know what it means to be a football fan.
Pulling me through.
May I see your driver's license, please?
Well, as it happens, I was down at the New Pike in Long Beach and fell out of my pocket. You know how it is. I just lost it.
Well, you know you were going 50 miles an hour in a 35-mile zone.
Officer, this car wouldn't go more than 35 if you shoved it off a cliff.
Have you been drinking?
My brother and I had one. Two screwdrivers, but we're not drunk, if that's what you mean.
Can you step out of the car, please?
You catch me if I fall now. I wrote that.
You're quite a comedian.
You really think so?
Unit 12 arriving behind you. Repeat. Unit 12 arriving behind you.
One foot in front of the other. Walk that line.
Two LAPD units en route.
Should have seen me on Shindig. Oh, man, I'm not drunk. Can't you see I'm a good fella? Wouldn't try to diddly bop nobody.
What do you got?
The deuce.
Oh, come on, man. You don't have to give me a ticket to take me to jail. I live right around the corner. My brother Reggie can drive the car home. I can walk. Look, he's an excellent driver, and me, I walk real good. I'd appreciate it.
Just skip this out, all right?
Close back up.
It's on its way.
You know better than to drive after you've been drinking.
Mama, I am not drunk.
Child, don't tell me that. I can smell liquor all over your breath.
Look, I am not drunk, and I'm not going to jail.
Now, Dominique. Now, come on, Dominique. Now, you're going to have to come with
me. I'm not taking me to a son of a bitch in jail, man.
Let's just cuff him and get the hell out of here.
Look, why don't you just kill me?
Uh-oh, man. Here comes PD. Here
comes. You're going to have to kill me before you take me to jail. I'm not going to jail.
Damn police for one
bar! I'm not going to jail, man! I'm not going to jail!
Let me get him down!
Get off me!
What are you doing to my baby?
Let's go, my brother, man! Let's go, man! Let me go, man!
No!
Put him down! Get her off me!
What in your hand there, all right?
Come on, leave! Hit those white dogs! You can't do that woman like that!
Good.
I want Fradkin and Gunn on the scene now.
I got a car. Okay.
Go.
After Heat Wave, an innocent black man is charged with... This motion picture contains language that may be objectionable. Viewer discretion is advised.
By the evening, the arrest of the two brothers and the rumor about a pregnant woman being beaten by the police had set the stage for a night of violence.
Come on, 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 come on
Central receiving, they're going to be okay. But Bill, the Riders are going after whites. The press is getting clobbered. I just got off with UPI. Nick Beck got his back slashed.
Who else is down there?
Everybody. Reuters and BBC have sent in extra staff, though a lot of good it's going to do them.
So you're telling me that we have got an international story brewing in our own backyard and that we can't cover?
Well, the LAPD is furnishing us with releases on an hourly basis.
Damn it! I need a Negro reporter.
Well, what about pulling somebody from another department?
Great idea, Art. Take a look around.
Mr. Thomas, I live in Watts. It would be very easy for me to enter the right area and report back everything I see.
Who the hell are you?
This is Richardson from the mailroom. He's the guy you had drive Pratkin and Gaunt. He got us the cowboy tickets.
Forget about it.
I took journalism courses in college. I can quote you Ambrose Bierce and Edward R. Murrow chapter and verse. I'm a messenger at this paper because it was the only way I could get a job.
Listen, kid, just because you're a Negro does not make you a reporter. I need a journalist, not an opportunist. I cannot use you.
You can't use me? I just saved two of your white reporters' asses.
What about Wilson and UPR?
What about me?
You're not qualified.
All due respect, sir, I'm the only one in this entire building who is qualified.
What do you think, Hart?
I'd go with him.
All right, get him a credential. Everything you see, you phone in to Art.
Fine.
Don't take unnecessary risks. You get in, do your thing, get out. Clear?
Yeah, clear.
Now get down there. Okay.
Whoa. What are you doing out here, boy?
Hey, I'm pressed, all right? I'm pressed, all right?
Hey, oh. I know this guy.
All right.
You hear me?
This has become a habit with you. What are you doing out here, especially tonight? Covering the riot.
How long have you been a reporter?
About an hour.
What, is that girlfriend of yours the boss's daughter or something, or what?
Be careful.
Don't you dare come down here. I'll be okay. You stay put where it's nice and safe.
Listen. You see Bobby, you tell him I said be careful now. Them police won't be able to tell one black face from another.
That would be a switch, wouldn't it?
Take care of yourself, child.
I'm not. I love you too, my dear.
After the LAPD regrouped behind the staging site at Imperial, the mob began to vent their rage at any whites that happened to enter the area. No sooner was a white spotted when cries of, quote, get whitey, erupted everywhere. And that's what I got for now. Art, hold on a minute. Something happened to me tonight. Ever since I arrived here in Los Angeles, we used to have this kind of ritual where every year, first Saturday in September, my grandmother used to take my best friend and me down to the Robin shoe store. And she'd buy us these brand new shoes to wear with our Sunday best or for school. It's a big deal. Tonight, as I stood there and watched the Robin shoe store go up in flames, this cop comes up to me and he tells me to leave the area.
Didn't expect him to understand that as that store went up in flames, so did a part of my childhood.
Richardson just phoned this in. I think you better read it.
Kid wrote this?
It's pretty good, huh?
It's better than good. Right. As is.
Wave will return in a moment on TNT.
The irony of my big break coming on the misfortune of the black community was not lost on me. All of the years of preparation only to witness my people involved in a violent struggle with the police took any pleasure from my own good luck.
He had no idea, Sugar. None. He just opened up the front page and there it was.
Well, I think it's great.
Yeah, I'm kind of looking forward to reading it myself, huh?
How does it feel to have a celebrity in the family?
Oh, I'm proud of Bobby. Real proud. I just hope he's careful.
Hey! Blood hungry mobs, huh? Uncle Tom bastard!
Get on out of here.
You working for the white man?
Where's the part where those white dogs beat up my punter, man? What did you see last night? It sure as shit ain't what I saw.
Lots of blood on the street and you say it's Whitey's blood?
Well, pretty soon you're gonna have to decide what team you're playing for.
I mean, Junius, I'm not blind to what goes on down here. I live here, too. I wrote what I saw. You think I'm an Uncle Tom? So what the hell am I?
A man. Part of being a man is handling those people who don't like you or who don't believe in what you're doing. You keep on being your own man. Look deep into your heart and tell the truth. Not the white man's truth, not the black man's truth. There's only one truth. Here, you take this. My daddy gave me this when I became a man. I'm passing it on to you. You've earned it, son.
Doing?
Hey, well, I'm gonna be off duty as soon as this rally's over.
Look, I think I owe you a drink. I'll meet you at Jeff D's after. All right?
My friend, we have got to stop.
Don't you see that violence carries with it the seed of its own destruction? Yes, we have grievances. But together with the right strategies, we can work them out. There is yet time. But for us to consider matching violence with violence, it's just the wrong way. Pure and simple. The wrong way. It's wrong.
I got two sons, and I'd just as soon see them die in the streets of Watts as in Vietnam.
Dad,
is not the way. Now, we want our rights, but we don't want to have to fight the police to get them.
There you have it.
The way the police mistreat you around here, I'm gonna tell you something. It ain't gonna be all that lovely tonight, whether y'all like it or not. Cause we the Negro people have grown completely fed up. Yeah, they ain't gonna fight down here no more. You know where they going? They going after the whiteness. Yeah, they going after Inglewood, Playa Del Rey, and everywhere else the white man's supposed to stay. Yeah, they gonna do the white man here tonight.
We don't need this in here.
Wait a minute. The young man is expressing an isolated opinion.
No, he's not.
If you broadcast his statement, you're gonna cause a lot of trouble in this city. A lot of trouble.
Earlier today at Athens Park, Peace Valley, this ominous warning.
Yeah, they going out to Inglewood, Playa Del Rey, and everywhere else the white man's supposed to stay. Yeah, they gonna do the white man in tonight. Leave him alone, man. That's right. That's right.
The incident was sparked by the arrest of a drunk driving suspect at 116th and Avalon Boulevard. The fire department was called to two general alarm fires at 115th and Central.
How about you and me? You've been like my mother my whole life. What only interview us?
It ain't about you and me, Jason. Nothing in this God world could tear us apart. You hear me? What, don't you know if anyone were to come up here and try to hurt you, I would be like the wrath of God descending on them.
Did anyone order a 12-gauge? Bob? Yeah, it's a shotgun?
Yeah.
How much is this one here?
This has five rounds and...
Richard? What is this?
What's it look like, honey?
We have a young son in this house. I want this out of here.
I'm sorry, I can't do that.
Why?
You've been watching the TV. You know everything that's going on out there. It's not enough that they want to burn and loot their own area. They want to do us in, too. I'll tell you one thing. These savages aren't coming into my house and hurting my family.
What the hell's the matter with you? Have you lost your mind?
I gotta go.
You call me a sack, Mr. Cave. Me, who's been a part of this family for over 10 years. Don Joe Sucks, wash your underwear, and raise your child. How do you think you would feel if every dream you ever had for yourself and your loved ones was always close enough to see? Close enough to touch. You might be filled with the anger and frustration that nothing would ever change. That's the thing makes people burn, Mr. Kenville. And it's fear that men like you, good men, bring shotguns into their homes. you, Mr. Kinfield. I'm gonna pray real hard for you.
Heat Wave will return in a moment on TV.
I've this beach for a long time. They have hundreds of reservations. And so, of course, there isn't anything more especially that I could do in the next few hours. But I'll go up and write back to keep my commitment. But if it hadn't been made for months, I certainly wouldn't go.
The mayor of Los Angeles kept a fundraising appointment in San Francisco during the largest domestic insurrection of modern times.
There could not have been a more eloquent statement of the city's priorities.
I gotta tell you, you must have some kind of angel looking out for you to come out of last night without a scratch.
Be careful. I heard that if there's any trouble tonight, we're gonna have to crack down hard.
Thank you. I have to keep that in mind.
I know I'm new around here, and I'm still catching on. But when I worked at Hollenbeck, even after I worked here, the 77th, for a couple of months, people knew me on a first-name basis. A lot of them trusted me. Hell, some of them even liked me. But at the very least, they respected me. You don't know what it's like, Bob. Never in my life have I been hated so much by so many different people.
It's not a personal thing.
How do you change things? How do you even start?
Such a bad place.
Blood no more. I'm talking to the white man now.
Hey, wait a second. You want to talk to the white man? This microphone, this is the white man. Whatever you say goes in this machine. You really want to talk to the white man, this is your shot.
Oh.
Talk to him, brother. Talk to him.
You are hurting me. You are hurting me, and I want you to stop it right now.
Come on, Pete, man. Let's go.
outside. We need help. We need help.
Juniors.
Burning now and everything about me. I tried to stop them, but they wouldn't listen.
Come on, Juice. Let's go home. It's gonna be okay.
You're too young to remember, but Central Avenue used to be the jewel of Los Angeles.
Okay, okay.
Spots like Club Alabama, Nemo, Downbeat. They come down here to see America's royalty. Duke, Accountant Earl, Ellington, Hines, Basie. Nina Horn, Lady Day. White folk from all over town come down here to swing and bop with the soul poke. I gotta stop them before they burn down the avenue. Oh.
What the hell are you doing here? Get out of here before you get killed. Now, get out of here. Go.
Go right there, looter. Come here. Get your hand behind your back.
Stay back.
Go.
Go. Go. Go.
Gun. Gun.
Oh, hey.
Drop it. Drop it.
A merit badge. What the hell does it look like? We're winning the war. This army don't take no technicolor niggas. It's time for you to join up, Bobby.
Can't do it. I can't do it.
You got a man called Cocktail!
Get out of here! Let's get out of here!
After Heat Wave.
No longer why did the uprising happen, but why did it take so long to erupt? Riggs was dead. JT was defeated by hate. And Clifford was in jail. I needed to make some sense out of this madness.
Attack.
Just coming to check up on you, Junius. Why don't you go home and get some sleep?
Can't take any chances. Well, I got you here. How's your grandmother?
She's fine. She's up in Beverly Hills. Keep an eye out.
Does she know I don't smoke?
Yes, Junius.
Does she know I don't drink?
Yes, Junius.
Does she know I got a good business in all my teeth?
Yes, Junius.
My heart is still strong. Got a lot more ticks left in it. I'd wait forever for Ruth Ann if I had to. I love that little old girl.
Come get me, come get me, help me!
What's your baby's name?
Tiffany.
Hmm? What's her name?
Tiffany.
But you should do that, sweetheart. You lost your shoes too, didn't you? Well, we're going to find some shoes here to put on your feet, and then we're going to go try to find your mama. Yeah? Sit down with me a minute, sweetheart.
Land of opportunity lies an island of despair. It was forsaken place, victimized by social and economic discrimination. A white community which was not only unaware of where Watts lies geographically, but many were unaware that such a place existed at all. A chief of police who used his own officers as pawns. Sacrificial lambs in the name of maintaining the status quo. The same chief of police who characterized the Negro community as monkeys in a zoo. A news media which has historically seen fit to look the other way. Mayor who leaves the city to attend a $100 a plate campaign function only hours before the first of 15,000 troops will rumble into his city. While leaving a legacy of dead and wounded whose only crime was being at the wrong place at the wrong time. The city of Los Angeles may yet learn to understand and confront the hate that hate produced. The question is, will its people and their leaders have the guts to find the taste of ashes sufficiently bitter to do something about it? What is it you expect me to do with this?
I expect you to print it. I was told the Times hired you last year to open this paper up, make it something someone outside white suburbia would want to read.
Sit down.
No.
Oh, you're right. I was brought here to make some changes. And you are right again that we have not dealt with the Negro community.
Dealt with? We're invisible.
Look, this paper, like every other major paper on the West Coast, sees the Negro issue as a Southern issue. And yes, Bob, I want the Times to be the first to change that perspective, but it takes time.
A Southern issue? Look out the window, Bill. Look out there. 54 square miles of Los Angeles are going up in flames. Does that look like some damn nonviolent freedom march to you? Time is the one thing you ain't got.
And a sense of objectivity is one thing you ain't got.
A man I loved and respected more than anyone once told me to tell the truth. Not the white man's truth, not the black man's truth. He said there's only one truth. Right now, the only truth that matters lies 2 miles south of this building. No, it wasn't supposed to happen here. Anywhere else, but never here. Well, damn it, Bill, it's here. And if you don't take a stand right now, it's gonna keep right on coming home.
You realize if I run this story, there's going to be hell to pay. For all of us. Your shot at being a journalist could easily go right down the toilet. You understand that?
You have to print this.
You know, Ruthanna, in time, everything works out. It really does.
Hey, man. You told the truth.